People in the St. Pete art scene have been really busy getting ready to reveal a new space that they're calling the Factory. And right now, they're in the process of getting their first tenants. New here at 3, ABC Action News reporter Robert Boyd has a sneak peek.
Well, right now, this is just some old warehouse space. But in less than a year, the goal is for it to be the most happening spot for the arts in all of St. Pete. In South St. Pete, there are 8 empty warehouses spread out over 6.5 acres that no one paid much attention to until now.
St. Pete's vibrant, it's growing, it's art-focused, and now we're kind of giving it a dedicated mecca for where the arts can grow.
Kara Behar is one of the founding members of The Factory, set to open in the fall of 2020.
At the end of the day, The Factory is a series of buildings. It's only what we fill it with that matters.
And what she is in the process of filling this empty space with is a series of artists, nonprofits, and small businesses intertwined together.
The nonprofits pay either extremely reduced rent or they pay no rent whatsoever. In exchange for that, they are bringing in people that support the other businesses.
Two of the first tenants on board include Daddy Cool Records and the nonprofit literary group Keep St. Pete Lit.
I really think it's wonderful when the private supports the public, because grants can be fickle. But having people that have private businesses coming and supporting nonprofits is like a win-win for everybody.
Keep St. Pete Lit teaches writing classes everywhere, from elementary schools to senior centers. But Executive Director Maureen McDowell said they've never actually had a place of their own. The Factory could be a game changer.
So it's kind of like a family affair where we can have this creative incubator and also help activate the rest of the community and bring the community in.
In St. Pete, Robert Boyd, ABC Action News.